G'day fellow creatures of the internet, this is the most musty and subscribe going here on YouTube, Bruzo Dragonius. To be honest with you, I know that I didn't seem to make any videos as of lately because I think that I'm running a bit low on ideas, really. In that video playthrough of that last video of Video Game Nerd, it's just something that I just cooked up and all that kind of stuff. I didn't seem to get any fursuit-related content, whatever, or fursuit-related content. So, and I've still got none, but about this lockdown and all that, I'm just losing some of the other ideas to make videos. That is until I had encountered Captain Nota or Rico and all that kind of stuff. I mean, that brought me that package that I showed you that I got from Ferdu and all that kind of stuff. He suggested that, you know, I should just do something random and all that kind of stuff. Most likely, you know, a video to do with Shrek and all that kind of stuff. You know, listing some of my favorite Shrek moments and all that kind of stuff. And I would have thought, well, maybe it could be a bit random, you know. I don't think that there's any time to do anything about Shrek at the moment because it's not as relevant. But what the hey. So I'm just going to get down to five of my favorite moments of Shrek, of Shrek 1. So anyway, just roll the intro. The first one that I'm going to talk to you about is the start of the movie itself. The reason why that is one of my favorite part is that, you know, we get to see the start of the story where it's just taken onto its premise, you know, reading a book, you know, about a prince rescuing a princess from a dragon and all that kind of stuff. And then it just cuts to Shrek reading the book and it just seems to be a bit more, you know, say, yeah, right. Shrek, to me, is just mainly a piss take of all fairy tales and all that kind of stuff. And with Shrek saying, yeah, right. We then cut to him going out of his shack in this swamp to Smash Mouth All-Star. Now, I think that the movie itself came within the early 2000s. And All-Star from Smash Mouth, I believe, is somewhere in the 90s. Probably 97. I'm not quite sure, but yeah, it's been around even since I was a hatchling as well. And then you see with Shrek doing those disgusting things to keep clean and all that kind of stuff, such as brushing his teeth with mud, down to and also like having the mirror breaking and all that kind of stuff because, you know, he's an ogre and he's ugly and all that kind of stuff. Down to the part where he ended up being in a some sort of a pond and then he ends up farting and there's fish that came out there dead because, you know, ogres are really disgusting and they're very, very, they are just disgusting in general with all those things and even though that they're ugly. And there's this fish that came out and all that kind of stuff. And it just all come into random and type of things and all that kind of stuff. I mean, there's going to be some in the same scenes, but in no particular order. But number two is basically where they ended up being in this theme park. Well, it is sort of like a theme park, but it's more of a kingdom of the character that is Lord Farquaad. And they ended up going into there, and apparently with Donkey, he wanted to, you know, go and like explore the place around. You know, there's some really funny bits where this guy in his oversized Lord Farquaad head was really afraid of Shrek, so he just ended up, you know, running to the ticket boxes and then bang, he just got knocked over and all that kind of stuff. And then once that they go inside the park that was Duloc, Donkey wanted to have a check out on this exhibit, kind of like the animatronic things that you would see in Disneyland, or, for example, the Small World ride. But instead of this, there's this toll boxing, and then you got those little animatronic looking puppets that are just doing this this sort of dancing and all that kind of stuff, which is kind of funny and all that kind of stuff. I sort of done a TikTok thing of it, so and the thing that really the very funny bit is that with the those puppets tend to like bend over and say wipe your bends over, even though it's suggesting ass, but then the puppets just sort of just turn over like that and says face instead of ass, which is kind of like has a bit of adult humor, I should say. And the way that I'm meaning is that, you know, there's this, if you wanted to know what I mean, even though that I don't normally show footage of movies, but this is what I mean.
Welcome to Deluxe.
Farquaad. Apparently, he wants to be the king of Far Far Away and all that kind of stuff, so he's a villain of Shrek 1. And then you see him doing a bit of a interrogation and torture of what's known to be as the Gingerbread Man, which is a sentient cookie, just like in the story of the Gingerbread Man. And in this one, in this part, he was like interrogating to see, you know, to talk about the some sort of a princess or whatever, and he just took one of the two of the gingerbread man's feet, and then he goes, "One run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the Gingerbread Man." That is basically with that story and all that kind of stuff, and he just ended up saying, "Where's the princess?" or whatever. He just tortures him and made an intangent sort of answer where the gingerbread goes, "Do you know the Muffin Man?" And then Lord Farquaad says, "The Muffin Man? The Muffin Man? Yeah, I do know the Muffin Man. He lives on Drury Lane. He's married to the Muffin Man. The Muffin Man? The Muffin Man! Yes, I know the Muffin Man." You know, or something like that. It's just that with the scene by scene. And I don't know if it would lead on to the dating show, which is number 4. Which is one of my 4th favourites, where Lord Farquaad was like in bed or something like that. He talks to the mirror and all that kind of stuff. And even though that he wants to have a suitor or something like that, it's all this dating show type situation where Lord Farquaad is a contestant with all the 3 other choices, which is Princess Fiona, Sleeping Beauty, Snow White, you know, and all that kind of stuff. And it comes down to this dating show where some of his minions were like, you know, helping him choose, like, "Choose 3, my lord," or something like that. He ended up choosing Fiona, of course, because, you know, that's where the story goes. And, yeah, that's as much as I could remember. And there's this other scene where basically they had a bit of a tournament, you know, of the winner gets to go out and fight this dragon to save the princess, of course. And it turns out that Shrek is only out there because of Duloc, because of some of the some of the fairy tale characters have been dumped in his swamp and wants to get his swamp back. But it wasn't meant to be this case where he ended up going to save the princess. But however, Lord Farquaad ended up like saying, well, everyone getting up on Shrek and whoever has his kills him gets to go out to save the princess and all that kind of stuff. So it ended up being New Generation, but I think Courtney Love, which you probably would know that from American Chopper or, you know, Ronda Rousey's theme song if you're a fan of wrestling. And it ended up being like a wrestling ring type paddock. You know, it's just all set up. And there's like a bit of a wrestling match between the two guards and Shrek and Donkey and all that kind of stuff. And the Shrek ends up winning that fight. And they ended up going out there to, you know, save the princess from the dragon. And the last thing that I wanted to talk about, which is one of my favorites, is the way how the Donkey, I mean Donkey, which is first voiced by Eddie Murphy, ended up being stranded. And then he ends up seducing this dragon and all that kind of stuff, which, you know, the dragon's really flattered, you know, and it turns out to be a girl dragon, and it's kind of so much of Donkey. And the dragon ends up falling in love with Donkey and all that kind of stuff in the story. So anyway, there's just my five favorite Shrek moments in that. This was this video is just on the go. If you do like this video, make sure you press the thumbs up button. Please consider subscribing to this channel, as well as the usual other social medias that I'm on, or ways to buy me money is also on the description below. The next video will be out is pretty much another ESL video. Hope you look forward to that. Also, if you do like my content or something like that, please consider giving me money, or better yet, supporting me by subscribing to this channel. To those that even watch this to the end, and especially those who subscribe to this channel, thank you so much. I really do appreciate your support. You're all amazing. Defriend me on PSN. Also, my gamer tag is Elbruder21, or if you want to look out for me on ESO, whether I'm in Tamriel, that's the PSN gamer tag. I'm just going to wrap it up by saying, this is must-see and subscribe to Argonian and online ambassador Black Marsh, Bruzo Dragonius, saying, I love yous, yous are amazing, and as always, may he scourge you all. Bye for now.